Hi, everybody. I'm still working with sound settings, so I'm gonna make sure. Okay, I think we're good. So, we're playing some more Trauma Team today. I know it's been a little while. I've been obviously cycling through a mix of games, but back with more Trauma Team. I have my laptop in my lap. I might have to move it because the mic is really quiet today for whatever reason, and I don't want to shout. Oh god. Okay. But, ooh. This cord is twisted. So, okay. I don't need a Wii strap. I'm a responsible adult who's not going to throw my Wiimote at the TV. Oh, this is okay. There we go. Alright, let's continue. Maximum annoyance. Alright, who am I on? I think I'm on Tomoe. Yep. Alright, let's do it. She was going to Japan because something was up with her father. I just don't remember if they specified what.
Lady Tomoe, they are ready to see you now. I will be right there.
Have you heard? It seems Lady Tomoe has returned.
Of course she has. Her leaving this place was a mistake.
This family needs her. She needs to stop playing.
Announcing Lady Tomoe. It's been a while, Father.
She's so pretty.
Indeed. Have a seat.
I'm glad to see you are well. I'd been told you were ill.
The elders leap to conclusions. Merely a lung problem.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that.
However, it is true that I'm not as young as I was. The elders feel that the clan succession must be decided.
I cannot presume to understand what you mean by that.
It is simple. I will find a suitable husband for you.
An arranged marriage?
Will the lady refuse? This is unprecedented.
Selfish girl. She takes the Tachibana clan too lightly.
I shudder to think what will happen in the future.
And it's funny because they're the ones being selfish.
I humbly...
Whoa! Hold it right there!
Oh, what in the world?
Intruders! Intruders amongst the clan!
The chief? Dr. Cunningham?
Yo, Tomoe! We came to rescue you!
I fly to Japan for a conference and get dragged into this. Give me a break.
Who are they? What happened to the guards?
Are these the kind of people our lady is associating with?
Such insolence! Seize them!
You fools! Be silent!
You two are from America. Are you here to take Tomoe back?
Of course! Tomoe is one of our trusted doctors and a friend. We're not going to let her be given away without her consent.
Hmm. I have yet to hear an answer from my daughter. Tomoe.
My answer? Father, I...
This isn't good! Master!
A doctor! Call a doctor!
You've got at least two right there.
Hurry up!
What? Panicking on the battlefield is not the path of honor. Goto, call for a doctor. Ikeda, ready a bed. Get water!
Yes, milady.
Water! The lady requests water. Make haste!
Father!
He's got tension pneumothorax. He'll go into arrest soon.
What kind of man is this guy? I can't get a needle in.
You require an open airway. Stand aside.
Has that been sanitized?
All right, it's in. We've cleared a way for the air to escape. Now what? How can we operate if a scalpel won't cut his skin?
Hanzo, my tools! Prepare for an operation.
Hey, what are you gonna do?
If the cause is a ruptured bulla, we can close it off. I can seal the hole in his lung with fibrin glue.
It's worth a shot. Let's do this.
Yes.
His right lung is leaking air into his thoracic cavity. We don't have any more info, so we'll have to look around.
Understood. Beginning the operation.
Okay. First aid for tension pneumothorax causes assumed to be a ruptured bulla in the right lung. Let's do this.
There isn't a moment to lose. Hurry and find the ruptured area.
15 minutes, okay.
I understand. Time for my Tachibana style endoscopic skills.
Oh my goodness, it's so dark.
This... The inflammations in the lungs are hemorrhaging. We can't let it go on.
Hemostatic forceps are ready. Perform hemostasis on all of them.
Seems to be the thorax, pass the hemorrhaging, watch out for affected areas and search the lung. Alright.
The hemorrhaging has been treated. Let's move the endoscope further in.
Slowly.
There are affected areas. Is there something up ahead? We're done treating this area. Let's hurry up and go to the next. Hey, there are affected areas. Begin treating them.
Okay, that's fine.
Nearby affected areas have been treated. Moving on. Affected areas here as well. We won't lose. I'll treat them all.
Over the controls.
Treatment complete. Move on to the next one. There are affected areas all over. Start treating them immediately. It's hemorrhaging severely. We'll have to treat them while we proceed.
Yep, there it is.
Huh. Here it is. We found the ruptured bulla. There's severe hemorrhaging. Can we even treat it like this?
The hemorrhaging isn't stopping. It may be caused by something else.
Sorry.
Oh my god. Ah, Jesus Christ.
Alright, good. The fiber is good.
The blue form is sealed. You can do this.
Aw, oh, come on.
The blue's been flushed away. We have to start over.
Yeah, I know. I'm aware.
This isn't good. It won't stop until we find the source. We need to find what's causing this hemorrhaging and fast.
Can I go the other way? Find what's causing the hemorrhaging. Okay. Ah, here we go. Okay, it's that way.
I see more affected areas further on. There's gotta be something.
The good thing is though, oh, here we go.
This, it's a thrombus. It's disrupting the bloodstream around it.
Bloodstream? Dr. Cunningham. Could this be the cause of the hemorrhaging?
I see. This thrombus is increasing the local blood pressure, and the hemorrhaging makes sense.
I'm going to treat the thrombus. Doctor, please support me.
Yeah. Listen carefully. Treating the thrombus is almost the same as dealing with a tumor. First, inject the affected area with medicine so it protuberates and can be excised. Be careful how much medicine you inject. Too much and it'll burst.
Oh, vitals. Don't you die.
On to the next treatment.
All right. We should be able to treat the pneumothorax now. Let's go back to where it was.
I don't remember. Was it this way? Is it this way and down? Nope. That way. And to the left.
Alright, good. The fibrin glue.
The glue formed a seal. We can do this. Keep it up.
The glue solidified. It's gonna be alright. Keep going.
Operation complete.
Oh, okay.
We were able to save him. Father.
Whew. Almost gave me a heart attack there. Glad he'll be okay, though.
We did it. Oh my god, that was actually tough. Okay, cool. Did I get a S? Oh, not. Okay. Those are really hard.
Well done. We pulled through. Somehow.
Yes, thank you very much. I don't know what would have happened if you weren't here, Doctor.
You'd have saved him on your own. It's your skills that saved him, you know.
We did it. Can I stay a doctor now?
You've awakened, Master.
Where is she?
We have loaned her a jet. She is likely returning to America. The elders had no response to her excellent reactions.
I see.
Oh, I nearly forgot. Lady Tomoe has left a message for you. I must learn more if I am to master the Way of Honor.
Hm.
that minx. So, she has no intention of returning, then. Anzo, it is your duty to watch over Tomoe. Go.
You mean...
What use does our clan have with an untrained girl?
Very well, then.
How's he laughing?
Wow! This plane's crazy! Can we sit anywhere we want?
Of course. It belongs to the Tachibana clan.
Stop getting excited over everything. Getting a meal?
Yes, of course. Feel free to have as much as you like.
Hey, are you sure you're okay with leaving your butler?
Hanzo, he has served me well for all this time. I cannot force him to come along with my selfishness.
Well, don't worry. Just hire yourself a younger, hotter guy.
I thank you for your unnecessary concern, Dr. Cunningham.
Oh, how long have you been standing there, Gramps?
Hey, what the hell?
What? Don't blame me. You saw him sneak up on me.
How shameful to attempt to me, Dr. Cunningham. This light on my heart demands you perform some...
Screw that! I'm a samurai!
Until we meet again, Father.
No samurai. Wake up. Oh wow. Oh wow. Okay. I have a wild flash to do with her next one. Okay. So let's do Maria. I like her.
What's up?
I worked really hard today. So Darnell said he'd treat me to dinner. You want to come with?
I offered to take her, but she keeps inviting people.
Sorry, I'll pass. Good for you, though. Eat up.
What? Do you have other plans, Dr. Torres?
I guess she doesn't understand that it's
on.
A date.
Let's not bother anymore. Let's go, Emma.
Oh, all right. We'll see you later, then.
This is so not like me.
Oh. I was confused for a second. She's just lying there.
Now this is new. Something bothering you?
Leave me alone, big guy. Well, this is just me thinking out loud. Seriously, we'd all be better off without all these morons. Why can't people get it through their heads that I'm right?
Hmm. Why are you so focused on being right?
This might sound dumb, but I wanted to be a hero.
A hero?
Yeah. When I was 14, I accidentally started a fire at my orphanage. I was smoking in the bathroom and it got out of control. But while I was running away, I heard a voice cry. I ran back and saved her. I didn't even think twice about it.
What's wrong with that? You saved a life. That's good.
What's so good about it? I'm the one who started it, remember? Still, the kid I helped kept thanking me over and over. That's all she said. Thanks. Stupid, but it made me happy. That's when I made up my mind. I decided that I'd be an awesome hero who would save people.
Have you stayed in contact with the child you rescued?
Huh? Oh, that reminds me. I heard a letter came for me. I've been so busy that I haven't had time to get it.
I see. There's an important point you're missing.
Huh?
There's a limit to what even a hero can do by himself. A hero acting on his own only acts in vain.
I guess he would know.
Hey, Hank! What's the matter? You leaving?
Yeah. I'm going back to my room.
What's with that guy?
Oh, that is a bottle of alcohol. Okay.
A hero acting on his own only acts in vain.
Also, she lives in a shipping container. She's a doctor. Not a shipping container, a storage container. That's not creepy.
What? You again? What the hell do you want from me, huh? That again? Beginning? What's beginning? I'm tired of all these idiots. Go away! Get out of here! Huh? What the? Did some goddamn numbskulls run their ship aground?
The hero.
Move it! I'm from Resurgam First Care. I'll take over here.
Don't be stupid. We need to cooperate to save these people.
I'll be fine. I can handle these patients myself. Go over there.
All right. We'll leave them in your hands.
Screw you. Just get in my way, you boneheads.
A ship has run aground off Portland and exploded. Rescuers have begun saving passengers and crew thrown overboard. Do anything.
I can do this myself. Now let's get this done. Damn it, she's gone into cardiac arrest. She must have drowned. It won't be a problem. I'll start chest compression.
Oh, I don't.
Damn, how long do I have to keep doing this?
We just started.
Two more on deck. The explosion knocked them overboard.
What? Hey, somebody look in the ocean. There should be two more people out there.
What? Got it. We'll get a search team out there immediately.
Damn, this accident is a lot worse than I imagined. This isn't gonna be easy.
Give me this. There we go.
I need to fit it. Good. Now bring it around and tie it off. Good. Hemorrhaging.
I'm just gonna sit here and perform CPR. Can we just take her to the hospital?
Whoa, these are some nasty burns. What the hell was on that ship anyway? Hey, I'm gonna have to cut your clothes off, got it? Hey, hands keep shaking. Just do me a favor and don't move. This is terrible. These burns, they're second and third degree. I gotta hurry. That's the third one. Just a little more and it'll all be over.
I'm happy that worked.
Done. Hurry up and get her out of here. We don't have all day.
Hey, we searched the ocean and found those people you were talking about.
I'll take care of them. Shut up and leave them here.
Understood. They're in your hands now.
I'll do it. I'll do this.
Stabilized. Okay.
Damn it, she's gone into cardiac arrest.
Again?
Perform CPR. Okay, she's settled down. She'll be all right for a while now.
Yes, take her to the hospital.
Did she inhale some of the burning material? Her respiratory tract's completely blocked. Hey, someone get me a drain. What the hell am I doing? Of course there's nobody around. Just gotta treat it with the tools I've got. What do I have here? I've got a box cutter and some ballpoint pens. Okay, making an incision with the box cutter. His stomach's... This isn't good. He's got internal injuries, too. Hey, I'm cutting your clothing. Your life's more important than your wardrobe.
I don't think they complained. Okay, I know technically I should save the other person because they're not breathing, but... Oh my god. Oh yeah.
It doesn't look as bad as I thought it would. There's gotta be something.
Okay.
Alright, I'll treat these like hemostasis complete. Are you kidding me? This is a lot less severe than I expected. His condition suddenly taken a turn for the worse. Breathe, damn it! Come on, inhale! Don't tell me. Damn it, he's suffering from pneumothorax. Gotta make an incision. Antibiotic gel. I gotta use the gel to disinfect it. I don't have a damn scalpel.
Oh, don't tell me using the box cutters on the same person.
I'll use the pen to release the air. Gotta push it straight in, all the way into the thoracic cavity. It'll take some time for it to escape, though.
Don't mind me, I'm just jabbing you in the neck.
Right. I've made the incision. Now to insert the pen and secure an airway. I've cleared an airway. That should help her survive for a while. Damn it, are you serious? I don't have time to find a machine. I'll have to use some good old elbow grease. Aim for the center of her chest and hit her hard.
Oh. Hold A and swing the Wii remote downward.
How's that? Alright. Transport this one out! Hurry! Okay, he's calming down. Time to remove the pen. Hang on. Just have to pull it straight out, like how I pushed it in. Alright, but he's not gonna be able to breathe like this. I'll have to use some film and tape it down on three sides. The film goes on first. Okay, now to secure it on three sides with tape. Okay, one side taped. Next. One more to go. Gotta be precise. And it's secure. That'll help this guy pull through. It's over. Did I do it?
Hey!
We got another one!
Or not.
What the hell?
Oh, okay. That was actually okay to do more. Okay. I could have kept going.
Get him out of here, hurry! Somebody guide the ambulance.
We're out. Any more blood bags? Let me know if anyone needs
help.
We've
got another one. Help us get him off the ship.
Damn it! This is nothing.
Hey, are you all right?
Don't touch me. I'm fine. I can handle myself.
Don't push yourself so hard. Hey, someone help get this guy out.
We will. Yeah, I have a CRS-01 mission. But he's first, okay. Uh-oh.
Hank, what were you doing? You're late.
Oh, hey, Chief. Oh, sorry I'm late.
You're all out of breath, too. Odd. Where were you?
Out in the courtyard?
The courtyard, huh? Oh, what's your take on this, kid?
It's a lie. The courtyard is less than 90 seconds away. Even if he'd run from there, he wouldn't be breathing this hard.
I saw that, too. Where were you really, Dr. Freebird?
Well,
enough. I know you're all friends, but playtime's over. Let's begin the conference. About 10 minutes ago, a Ferris wheel collapsed in Oakdale. We're receiving 4 patients, one of whom is severely injured. The patient's name is Charlie Malone, a 39-year-old male. He has a steel beam in his abdomen and needs surgery stat.
He responded to this one with Maria.
So we have his ID. Has his family been notified?
That still needs to be done. Gabe, I'll leave that to you. Now, about the surgery itself.
Chief, if I may.
Huh? What is it, Tomoe?
Why not ask him to perform the procedure?
Me?
I've seen the video of his operation. He's better than us. Severe organ damage is anticipated and will need his skill.
I did see him in action. I agree. He's amazing.
Well then, it's decided. We'll count on you, kiddo.
What the? Hey, be careful!
Is this the urgent
patient?
Where should we take him? Has anesthesia been alerted?
Is everyone ready? Nurses, prep for surgery.
Please move. Make way.
Blood pressure 60 over 34. GCS is 3-3, blood type O plus.
Secure a blood transfusion line and get him to room A.
Let's move. You, get out of the way.
Please, listen carefully. This will require several steps. I will monitor the transfusion, so watch the patient's vitals. Doctor, is something bothering you?
I'm not worried, it's just...
Vitals flat! Doctor!
Damn it! Hang in there!
Readying the lactated ringer solution.
No time. Contact surgery. We're bringing him in as is.
Just...
How we handle this crisis will affect the hospital's name. Is it all right to trust this to an outsider like me?
You've let your short time here mislead you in understanding us. You aren't regarded as an outsider here anymore, Doctor. You've already saved 2 lives since you arrived here. All of us believe in our hearts that you'll save this man.
Believe.
Cardiac arrest, 1 minute. Hemorrhaging won't stop.
God damn it! We're not gonna let him die on us.
Let's go. Patient seems to have arrived.
Are they gonna be flatlined when I get them? I don't remember.
The extraction of the foreign object is a delicate procedure. I, Tomoe Tachibana, will be supporting you in this task.
Let's get to it.
We'll save this patient, no matter what.
Steel beam piercing the patient's abdomen. Patient currently in critical condition. Well, maybe they will be. Nope.
Very well. Let's do our best and begin the operation.
Patient's in critical condition. Let's be careful.
Doctor, the patient's undergoing cardiac arrest.
Charge the AED. Beginning resuscitation.
Oh god, no. Okay.
Activate the defibrillator when the gauge is free.
Oh god. Oh, they made it so much easier.
Back. Come on.
We have a pulse! Thank goodness!
Right. Resuming treatment of foreign objects.
It's possible that material like wires penetrated the organ. Use the ultrasound to see what condition the organ is in.
Bad extracting foreign objects. Do not drop them into the operation field. No problem for the search. Drain.
Alright. Beginning I-beam extraction.
Let's do this.
All right, I'll use the forceps while we can see it.
Please place the object in the tray.
The wire has been extracted. Moving on to other areas. Just need to pull this. The last shard has been extracted.
Last shard removed. Please continue with the blood is in the way. Please drain it quickly.
Let's just get all the other stuff out first. Save that one for last. Oh, you know what? I think I vaguely remember how this one goes.
The wire is bent within the wound. Be careful removing it.
Alright, let's do this.
Once we make an incision.
A blood pool is formed at the incision area.
Let's pull it with the forceps before the blood pools.
It's in so deep. We can't remove it all at once.
We'll have to open the wound and pull it out bit by bit. Ventricular fibrillation. Don't touch him.
All right. Probably did that because I touched it.
Pull on the object with the forceps. Watch the vitals.
We're halfway there. Continuing with the treatment.
The patient's getting worse. Doctor, what?
Not dying on me.
Just a little more. Hang in there, Doctor.
Vitals aren't stabilizing.
The object has been extracted. Please move it to the tray.
The object has been completely removed.
Okay.
You'll be okay for now.
Yes. Now
say we should probably put his organ back together. Is that his liver?
You need to do something about that blood. I'll suture it after blood. It's happening. All right. Now the suture. Prepare the sutures. Suturing completed. Let's use membranes as reinforcement. I see hemorrhaging in the operating area. Use the gel.
You're so precise.
Your operating skills are truly remarkable. We have a visual. There's hemorrhaging inside.
Oh.
I'm making an incision.
Blood
removal. The membrane came off because of a blood pool. The wound has been sutured. Moving on to other areas.
Alright, then we gotta get all this done.
One area remains. Still, you must be careful.
The wound is fully covered. The membranes have been affixed. This wound is large enough to need the pool. Alright, ready to suture the wound.
Large laceration treatment complete. Please continue.
Ooh. Oh my god. Okay, hang on.
Let's close this wound before another blood pool forms.
Bad. Bad. What? Okay, then how do I get
the wound before it opens again?
Vitals still aren't stable. There must be something hiding. Vitals still aren't stable. There must be something hiding.
Yep.
Vitals still aren't stable. There must be something hiding. Vitals still aren't stable. There must be something hiding.
Don't touch.
On the EKG. Please be careful.
Not touching.
Get the defibrillator ready. Come on. I'm back. Come on.
We have a pulse. Well done, Bobby.
I legit have no clue what's wrong. I'm so good at this game. Oh, there we go.
Vitals have stabilized. All treatment complete.
Alright, let's begin suturing the operation field. Let's close this patient up. Prepare the sutures.
Please place the bandage and begin the operation.
Injury.
You did it.
Oh my god. I've never gotten bad on sutures before. That's... Ooh, I'm getting really bad at this game. No mit- or... Okay. Ooh. Okay, I almost didn't get
you
pretty aggressive.
You're just as skilled as the rumors say.
Oh. That's why I'm here.
Such modesty. I have much to learn myself as well.
We did it.
Operation complete. Thank you for your assistance in the procedure.
He's really something. It's like a machine. Seriously, that kind of skill is just incredible. Right? Is that your daughter? She's a cutie.
That's right.
It's good she didn't take after her dad. How old is she?
She would be 14 now, if she were still alive.
When did she pass away?
Right.
She was killed in a bioterrorism attack 8 years ago.
8 years? Don't tell me. Oh, sorry.
It's in the past now.
That incident at Cumberland College.
My wife taught there. She passed away with my girl.
Hey, did they ever find who was responsible?
Yeah. I caught him. Personally. Don't you recognize him? He's standing right there.
Are you joking? He did that?
A side effect of the gas. It erased his memory. But he was found guilty in a court of law for it.
That bastard! Hey, Maria!
Well done, Doctor.
Uh-oh.
That was as smooth as last time. It's like nothing can stop you.
Emma, stop swooning over the new doc.
Hey! Convict bastard!
Hey!
Is it you?
Dr. Torres?
Did you do it?
What the...
What are you talking about?
Are you responsible for Cumberland College? Tell me!
I've already been put on trial for what happened there.
Damn it!
What are you doing?
So what then? Have you been lying to us all this time?
Please,
you're
calm down,
doctor,
Dr. Torres.
Damn it. We swore an oath to do no harm!
Dr. Torres,
security!
Calm down! Maria, stop it!
You can't remember, huh? Screw you! Start remembering! Remember what you did, damn you!
I'd like to return to my room. Could you escort me there?
Her baby. I got messes on all of this so far. So I did that one. Did hers. I think I have. Yeah, I gotta do her next. What about after him? Ooh, okay, I have diagnostics and forensics next. Start the episode. Daily trauma.
Hey, mister! It's your turn. You're gonna buy those or not?
Huh? I'm sorry. I'll just take this guy as well.
I mean, you already ruined it.
Thank you. Come again.
Something have happened?
Wait, so can he fly?
It'll be another 5 minutes before the doctor's helicopters get here.
Where's the stretcher? Someone take this patient out of here. Damn it, it's no use over
Quit
here.
Quit standing around.
Hey,
get stable victims ready
back.
For transport.
Allow me to help too, miss.
You're that Eagle Man from the papers.
That's just some bad press. Let's focus on saving this patient for now.
All right.
He has several broken bones. What hospital can take him?
Everywhere's full. We're sending the rest to Resurgam.
You're transporting them to Resurgam First Care? But...
Don't worry, our orthopedics department is top-notch. Hey!
Hey! Isn't that the Eagle Man?
That's him! He must have been behind all this!
What? No, I had nothing to do with all this!
No more excuses! Hey, police! Here's the culprit!
He's getting away! Get him!
Get back here, you filthy coward!
No! I'm not!
Where have you been, Hank? Stop playing around and get ready!
Oh, sorry.
What is it? Is there a problem?
No. But... I've lost sight of why we're saving people's lives.
Quit thinking about useless crap like that! There's a patient here! Now isn't the time for this!
You're absolutely right. Now, let's begin the operation.
multiple patients suffering various injuries caused by a ride collapse at a theme park. Oh, hey, she's my age.
We've got multiple patients this time, so let's treat them as fast as we can.
Indeed. This is our first patient. The wounds are in the right leg. Let's make an incision and see what's inside.
Did y'all not take an x-ray?
The tibia is chipped.
We should fill it with synthetic bone.
No.
Better do this quickly.
Wait, first we need to prepare the connecting area. Then we'll use the synthetic bone.
Okay, you're the specialist. I'll let you make the decisions here.
All right, then. Set the saw. Let's make an excision along the guideline.
Hold A, twist down. Oh, God. Okay.
Good. Cautiously continue on.
Oh, God, I hate this. I don't like this. I don't like that if you let go, you lose your chain.
That was pretty good.
I got it.
Now
we're good.
Prepare the connecting area. Now to form the synthetic bone. The shape to cut is already shown on it. Use the laser to cut it out.
Oh, God. All right.
Be careful.
Oh crap, I think this is the one where fragments might start flying off.
Ooh. Looks like you're on a roll. What was that static? We should wait until the guideline comes back.
Talking much, but I need to focus.
Huh. You're good. Yeesh. I think it's time we bought a new machine.
I guess that's also the game's way of being like, hey, here's your break without it being a break. Okay. Oh, that's stressful.
The synthetic bone's been shaped. Let's move on to the next step.
All right. Put the synthetic bone in the correct position.
Well done. Right, now to secure it with a plate. Prepare the drill.
Drill deep enough without touching the guidelines, okay?
Telling you how to do your own surgery.
Good. Cautiously continue on.
Good, good. It's going well. The femoral neck is the next step.
Ah.
This area has been completely shattered.
Looks
looks like we have no choice but to replace it with an artificial joint.
Right. Let's start this quickly. First, we have to extract the bone fragments.
It's not even inside her body.
All right. Keep going with the other pieces too, okay?
Hit the saw. We need to work on it so that the stem can be driven in.
Don't leave the guideline. Using a saw isn't like using a scalpel, after all.
Okay. Oh, wait.
Good, good. There's no need to hurry. Just be careful.
Oh, twist it. Okay, we're good. Oh my god, it's twist.
Good. Cautiously continue on.
I forgot how to do it.
That should do it. Can you bring out the stem?
Make sure it's secure, but don't hit it too far in. Got it?
Good. It's been driven into the right point.
Attach the ball joint. Drive it in up to the guideline, okay? Alright, that's it. Continue on.
Okay.
Now treat the acetabulum. Go slow and careful, right down to the guideline.
Scraping bone, slowly tilt. Stop and reach the guideline, okay?
Give me the cup. I'll begin attaching it.
Drive it down to the guideline. Watch how much force you use. Alright, attachment complete.
Now, let's fit in the hip joint. We'll be done with this patient's treatment then. All right, we're done here. Let's close up this patient.
Oh, that was stressful.
Here's the staple. Match the guide and staple the incision closed.
God, despite the numerous surgeries I've had, thankfully I've never been stapled shut. I've been sutured and glued.
Alright, let's proceed.
Honestly, I've been glued. Smaller.
Alright, bring in the next patient. We'll begin treatment immediately.
Which is nice.
The damaged area is the left leg. Let's begin the procedure.
Back is killing me. Let's finish taking care of this guy already.
I feel that.
Seem to be multiple fractures, and it looks like we can treat the cervical neck with pins. However, the rest of it's going to need to be secured with a plate.
That seems like the appropriate treatment. Let's start by collecting the bone fragments.
Hopefully he can keep his bone, right?
Alright, pieces have been picked up. Now put the fibula back in its original position. Put them back into place.
Doing well today.
Almost bad.
There's a total of 4 screws.
I got it, 4 screws.
Ouch.
securing the fibula. Get the drill. We'll just need a single hole for the pin.
Oh no. Okay, forget this. Yeah, realistically, you'd have a much longer bit.
Well done. Rock solid. Let's get this pin in there now.
Don't drive it in too far, okay?
It seems to be all right. Let's continue the treatment.
Like it's properly secured now.
Femur's next, right? Let's proceed.
Wow. This is severe. Will it need an artificial joint?
That'd be the best way. Let's scrape the neck and attach a cup.
Fit the guideline. All right, good. Keep it up.
Rock solid. It's firmly in place.
The acetabulum is next. Attach the cup over here as well. Careful now. Scrape it down to the guideline. Okay? Don't use too much force.
Nicely done. You're a damn fine specialist. All you need to do is care about your patients. Let's fit this on the leg. Treatment complete. Let's close this patient up and end this.
Oh, thank God. Is that it?
Ready the stapler. Closing the patient up.
All right. Oh my goodness. Well, they're not super particular. It's really
good. Well done. All the patients have been treated.
We pulled it off. All that's left is to hope the patients recover.
I hope so. Good morning. You have an artificial hip.
No problems. It went perfectly, as usual.
Any other patients? How was the surgical side?
Now the kid's handling those. They'll be difficult, but I'm sure you can pull it off.
Oh my goodness.
Well, now this is new. Something bothering you?
Oh, I was supposed to do his first. Makes sense.
That's when I made up my mind. I decided that I'd be an awesome hero who would save people.
Have you stayed in contact with the child you rescued?
Huh? Oh, that reminds me. I heard a letter came for me. I've been so busy that I haven't had time to get it.
I see. There's an important point you're missing.
Huh?
There's a limit to what even a hero can do by himself. A hero acting on his own only acts in vain.
Hey, Hank! What's the matter? You leaving?
Yeah. I'm going back to my room.
I'm gonna go sulk now.
Ah, been wondering where you were.
Oh, Gabe! Oh, sorry.
It's okay. You, free after this? Wanna grab some drinks?
Drinks.
Well, I mean, it's totally fine if you don't want to.
Actually, I'd love to come along.
Yeah, no worries. Maybe some other time. Or... what? You're actually gonna come?
Would that be a problem?
What? Of course not, big guy. And hey, it's on me this time, so just go nuts.
Well, I wouldn't want to overdo it.
What? You never come along. You're not getting off easy.
I'm just thinking about the voice acting in this game. It's like, I think I also like it because it sounds like normal people having conversations. Okay, I think for that one, I'm supposed to do Tomoe first. Oh, weird. Oh, a whole bunch on this. Okay, so it's him. Okay, so I'm gonna do surgery first, so we'll do that first.
A request for surgery. Is he still not,
It's a waste of time even speaking to him.
Why are you turning your back on everything? Look, if you just say you aren't the culprit, we'd all...
When I came to... When I came to, all I saw was a mountain of corpses. They were gone. Hollow eyes. Blood everywhere. I may have been the one that killed them.
Are you fine with that? What, you know for sure it was you? You're just running away. You can't hide from the truth.
Had enough. Please. Leave me alone.
Ugh! You fool!
I just want to hug him.
I brought your meal. Please, eat at least some of it.
It's all just a dream.
A dream?
I'm a prisoner. I'm different from everyone else. That's all there is to it.
So, Doctor, what do you think of him?
What do you mean? The kid's one heck of a surgeon.
I've been watching him a long time. I can't believe that he's the one who did it.
That's an odd thing to say. You're the one who caught him.
All we do is catch criminals. We don't decide their fate.
That's very noble of you. So, what do you want from me?
I think you'd agree. You and I have a lot in common. Look, we transferred him here hoping his memory'd return. I'd really like your help in our investigation.
Screw that. And you and I are nothing alike.
I'm not an idiot who'd force a doctor without passion to operate.
Treatment room 2! Hey, Darnell, where's Dr. Torres?
She went to get Dr. Cunningham. Go ahead and get ready for surgery.
I'll have everything ready in 5 minutes. I'll tell the nurses to prep for the operation.
Did you come to laugh at me?
I didn't hear any jokes. Sorry. Not my sense of humor.
It's all right. I heard your wife and daughter were...
Don't get me wrong. I'm only here because it's my job.
What?
The past is gone. But life continues. My wife fought to the end to save all her students. Just as the doctors here are fighting even now. But you... What are you doing? You're cleared for surgery. You ever dream about saving lives? Now's the time to start.
Dream about saving lives? I...
Cry if you want to. It's all part of growing up.
Careful with the anesthesia. It's a hearty procedure.
Yes, sir.
Respirator's ready. Get the curettes.
Doctor.
You?
Please let me do this operation. Please. Let me save this life.
The windblown hair is back.
The room is yours, Doctor. Now hurry up and get ready for surgery.
He's smoking in the OR.
We're dealing with Wormer syndrome here. Got it?
Oh, I did this out of order. Tumors found in the stomach, pancreas, and pituitary gland. Treat quickly due to risk of hemorrhaging. Yeah.
First, the pituitary glands, then abdomen and pancreas.
Understood. Please begin the anesthesia.
Yeah, I should have done diagnosis first. Oh well.
I made the incision into the cella turcica and dura mater. I'm handing the reins of this operation to you.
Yeah, leave it to me. First, we need to treat the blood pool. Let's use the drain. Tumor location confirmed.
Considering what we're dealing with, use extra caution.
That won't be a problem. I'll drain the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm removed. Beginning excision of the scalp. Tumor has been excised. Now extracted.
All right. We're making good time. Keep it up.
Stab this into your brain.
are these bruises?
Oh, just blood spots. They'll go away after this.
Understood. Beginning pancreas operation. There's a high amount of hemorrhaging and inflammations as well.
Is the bleeding from the GI perforation? We should treat it first.
Tissue near the tear is damaged by digestive juices. We'll need to excise the area around the hole to treat it.
Another blood pool is formed.
All right, let's close the wound. I'll need four.
It'll open up again, so suture it.
All right, perforation has been sutured.
Not so fast. I have some synthetic membranes here. Put them in place to reinforce the wound.
Don't take too long. The sutured area is covered. Moving to the next affected area.
Treat inflammations with medicine from the dark blue vial.
Inflammations have subsided.
Small tumors, huh? I'll get the laser and gel ready to use.
Moving operation field. Should be other areas.
Use the magnification tool then. Look for hidden tumors.
Can I get all this?
Stabilizing. Must be something.
Tumor presence confirmed. Moving it to the...
Don't forget to treat those small...
Excision complete. Moving on to the next treatment.
Take care of any remaining wounds.
Pancreatic treatment complete. Let's go to the next area.
Yeah, this next part's the last one. I'm counting on you.
All this blood. Where's this hemorrhaging from?
We need to treat all of it. Keep an eye on the vitals.
Vitals are pretty good, honestly.
The other areas.
Tumor confirmed. incising tissue near the perforation. Scalpel. Draining blood pool. Ready to drain. Now closing before another. Suturing the wound before it opens. I'll need sutures.
What?
The needle fell in? Damn it. Why at a time like this? We don't have much time. The patient won't last long.
Set the ultrasound wavelength for multiple analysis.
The ultrasound? What's that gonna do?
The needle's metal. It'll appear as a shadow if we scan.
All right. The ultrasound's ready. Let's hurry.
Oh my god.
Close up the operation field, and we'll be done.
I see the blood spots are gone.
Yeah, all thanks to one skilled surgeon.
Closing the operation field. Prepare the sutures.
Man, you sure can take the compliment.
Ow!
Taping the sutured incision, and the operation's done.
Operation there
complete. This disease is past from this world.
See, that's a disease.
Well, you know, to be serious for once, thanks for saving this patient.
Oh my goodness. Needle only lost? You can lose the needle more than once?
Something. Whoa, this isn't time to be depressed, kid. Be proud of yourself.
We did it.
Here. You're such a sucker, kid. No, but I mean it. Really something.
That was an amazing operation. Thank you.
It's all right.
Come, I'll escort you back to your room. Something wrong?
No. Let's get going.
Hey, would you mind coming somewhere with me first? I gotta run some papers down to emergency. You can lock a man up, but you have to respect his wants. Especially if it's something honorable. Hey, here we are. What do you think of the building? Seen better days, huh?
I'd assume so.
Now, this is the old ward. The rest of us moved into the new one. But emergency's still here. Do you know why? The people here wrestle with life and death every day. They're under more intense pressure than most can imagine. It can make them sensitive to serious issues about life.
Yeah.
Well, somehow I doubt they'll move to the new ward.
Now go on. Be right back. Gotta take this report to the medical office.
Stop by the service department, too. They paged us earlier.
Okay, I'll stop on my way back. Oh, excuse me.
If you have Hank's papers, you can drop them there.
All right.
I'm chill now.
Fixed. You piece of crap. What's the use? This ward's such a pain. Is it too much to ask to have working lights?
I see. Yeah, that's, unfortunate.
You still need something?
No. No, it's nothing. Sorry.
It wasn't you, right? You're not the one behind the terrorist attack, are you? You have no memory, but you just want to scream it out. Am I wrong? That's how I was when I was a kid. I think I lost my temper the other day. I'm sorry.
No, I...
Anyway, I know you aren't a murderer. At least, I don't think you are. So, let's drop it.
Why are you being so...
Hey, I got a lot to do here. You mind?
Wait, I'd still like to...
Bastard! What the hell did you break?
I didn't mean to. I was just...
If you just quit moping, it wouldn't have happened.
No, no. My personality has nothing to do...
Damn it, just shut up already.
It was going so well.
Yeah, the patient made it. I called in a special surgeon.
I see, and the cause of it all? Could it be an epidemic?
I can't say. Like you, I'm getting a bad feeling here.
We need to look into this as soon as possible, then.
Yeah, you're right.
Gabe, you sound tired. Did something else happen?
Nah, it's nothing. I've just been fed up with myself lately.
What's wrong? You don't seem like your usual self.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Anyways, try and get over here as soon as possible.
Well, all right.
Of course I am. Some of us can't loaf around on the job.
How sweet. I'm gonna let that one slide. Your patient's being discharged today, but she wants to see you.
The lady with Kaposi's? I wasn't the one who saved her. If she wants to talk to someone, call her surgeon.
Oh, hell no! That guy is a serious asshole!
Whatever. I don't plan on going down there either. Anything else?
Yeah. There's one more thing.
So many cigarettes.
We're understaffed and the chief wants you to take this one.
Is that all? Well, give it here. But the patient's... Joshua?
Well, if you don't want to, I can ask another doctor.
What kind of doctor would I be if I chose my patients?
Poor thing. It's his son.
Ronnie, let's start the diagnosis. Bring up the charts.
Yes, Doctor. The patient's name is Joshua Cunningham. He is related to you by blood, Doctor.
Is there a problem?
Negative, but I can request a new doctor if you prefer.
I'll be fine. Yeah, really programmed you well.
I must take into account the feelings of those around me. Observing colleagues allows me to gather their emotional data.
Yeah, you're perfect. Now you just need to learn how to talk.
Alright, let's do this. Yeah, I should have done this diagnostic case because he tells you what the end result is. I just don't know. And it's
oh,
over.
Hello. You're a new doctor.
Yeah. Hello, Joshua.
Doctor, I don't hurt at all.
What? That can't be. I received a report from your nurse.
That's weird. I'm all right, really.
Well, let's check you out. If I can't find anything, I'll let you go back to your room.
Okay. I'm sorry, Doctor.
The thing is, I don't know if he actually recognizes his dad.
Roni, I'm beginning the diagnosis. Are you ready?
Yes, Doctor. You may proceed.
This guy looks a lot like me, and he has my last name.
I don't hurt at all. I'm just here because the nurse said I had to be examined. But I feel just fine. You think maybe she mistook me for some other kid? Oh, but don't blame her. She's real nice. She's always worried about me and does a lot. I wonder, maybe I did something bad. She was really worried about me.
Todd, he really does seem to be fine.
Huh? Yeah, I mean, there's nothing wrong with me.
Well, all right. But just to be safe, let's finish examining you.
Stethoscope. Can you lift your shirt for me? Okay, gotta listen to the Wiimote. Please. Okay. Right lung sounds good. Left lung sounds good. Sounds like something is off for a second. Abdomen's good. Big wave, medium wave. It's up, down, big, little. Okay. Up, down. Yeah, everything looks good. Like his comments because they're sad. I didn't think any son of mine would be this pale. Nope. I missed the dialogue, I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just a cough.
Huh? That looked rather strenuous. But it's just a cough? Roni, patient's hiding something. I'm continuing the exam.
Understood. Proceeding with the diagnosis examination.
I guess I can listen to you again. Okay, now his breathing is strenuous.
boy's breathing pretty rapidly. Roni, make a note of it.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Rapid breathing.
Heart rate's elevated.
His heart rate's increased. Is this a symptom? Roni, record this. I think this is a definite sign.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Increased heart rate.
It seems that earlier attack is causing symptoms to appear.
Just had surgery, too.
There it is again. There's no mistake about it. Hey, show me the hand you covered your mouth with right now.
Huh? It's nothing. Come on.
Jeez, this kid's gonna try and hide as much as he can from me, huh? I need to see what's on his hand. I need to get him to use his hands. What can I do?
There we go.
Yep. There's blood on his clothes. He still had blood on his hand when he lifted his clothes up. The boy coughed up blood a moment ago, and he tried to hide it. Roni, make a note that the patient has hematemesis.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Hematemesis.
Hey, kid, why are you trying to hide your symptoms from me?
Well, why would you say that?
I know you coughed up blood earlier. It's on your clothing.
Oh. It's just some blood. I'm full of this stuff. I'm fine.
Coughing up blood's not normal.
Seriously, who do you inherit this attitude from?
From you.
Well, we're done talking. I need you to undergo a few tests for me. Roni, get approval for an x-ray.
Yes, Doctor. The x-ray examination is now available.
Since he's the doctor, would he also be able to consent as the parent, or would that be a conflict of interests? Would it just be like, no, we gotta call his mom? Then I know most doctors don't treat their family because of that. It's
Doctor,
a con-
the x-rays are ready for viewing.
All right. I need to be thorough here. Can't miss anything.
Patient's stomach, okay.
In the gastric wall. The contrast medium is settled in it. Well, this is definitely proof. We can't make excuses anymore.
I agree, Doctor. New symptom observed. Caved in gastric wall.
I thought it was. I guess not. Why not try informing the patient of the abnormalities that were found on the x-ray? That might be useful in making him admit he has admit to the false statements he has made. That's pretty devious of you, I wonder where he picked it up.
I have proof that there's something wrong with your stomach. You ready to talk now?
That's it.
So he does have stomach aches. What an idiot. I bet they hurt a whole lot, too. Well, Roni, he's finally coming clean with us. You writing all this down?
Yes, Doctor. New symptom observed. Stomach ache.
Yeah, I don't feel like eating when it hurts. What's wrong with that?
An appetite.
You don't feel like eating, huh? Well, given your stomach's condition, I'm not surprised. Roni, make a note.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Lack of appetite.
Everyone keeps making a fuss about it, but it's nothing. Really? Doctor, I'm okay. Seriously.
All right. Now, is there anything else you're hiding? This is your chance.
I'm not hiding anything. I really am okay.
Man, little runt. Time to go back to the office and continue with the diagnosis.
He doesn't want to be in the hospital anymore, and I honestly don't blame him. Hospitals aren't fun.
Well, we have at least a few symptoms to work with, Roni. Let's start narrowing things down.
Understood, Doctor. Displaying diagnosis candidates.
Gastric ulcer. Symptoms include increased heart rate, tinnitus, rapid breathing, stomach aches, loss of appetite, caging gastric wall.
Is it a gastric ulcer? That's odd. Joshua already had endoscopic surgery recently. There's gotta be a reason for the relapse. Roni, let's continue with the diagnosis.
Yes, Doctor. Send the request to continue diagnosis.
Sudden relapse.
Something's wrong. The ulcers have returned.
I anticipate there is an underlying disease, Doctor.
Yeah. I just hope there's no other complications.
That would be very beneficial, Doctor. Should we begin?
Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
Sudden relapse of gastric ulcers has been confirmed. Continuing diagnosis determined the cause of relapse. Diagnosis. Phase 2.
You're having a relapse of gastric ulcers, which I'm guessing hurts a lot. Why do you keep trying to hide your symptoms from me?
There's nothing wrong with me. I really didn't notice it.
Just stop it. There's no way you're all right. Now listen to me. I don't know why you're pretending to be fine, and I don't care why. But the more you keep this up, the more you make everyone around you worry about you.
But...
Whoa, there's no need to explain. If you don't want to talk about it, then that's fine. I've gotten permission from Lisa. I mean your mother, already. Roni, get the examinations ready. If he's not going to talk, then I'll find out myself.
Understood. Doctor, please calm down.
Sorry.
The X-ray, no. CT, and analysis exams are now available.
Poor baby. Okay. Blood pressure's fine. Hemoglobin's fine. That is not.
Serum amylase seems unusually high. Roni, add that to our list.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. High serum amylase level.
This is also high.
Serum lipase level is a bit higher than I'd like it to be.
You know, just double what it should be.
Roni, record that.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. High serum lipase level.
His elastase level is elevated. Roni, you got that?
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed.
Take a look at him.
Okay.
Hmm. There's an abnormal break in the bowel gas. Roni, record that.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Abnormal bowel gas in intestine.
Make a note of it.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Swollen pancreas.
Got a lot more to go off of now.
Doctor, we need the patient's cooperation for any further examinations.
I'm trying to figure out how to wear these. It doesn't hurt.
Yeah, you're right. I should try talking to him again.
I just go talk to him, so come on, dog.
Well, I may have been a bit harsh earlier. I wasn't being professional. But you also...
Doctor.
I know. Just be quiet. Anyways, I want to cure you completely. And everyone is worried about you. Joshua, will you please cooperate with the exams?
Sorry.
Huh?
I'm sorry.
Hey. Hey. It's all right. Don't cry.
I don't know how to handle this. This is the opposite of my job.
But it's all my fault. I didn't want my mom or that nurse to worry about me.
But Joshua...
I'm really sorry. I just made everyone worry even more. I won't hide anything anymore. I want to get out of this hospital. So,
please.
Yeah, I understand.
Actually, my tummy feels a little weird. Can you check it out, Doctor?
Of course. Leave it to me. Roni, are you ready?
Yes, Doctor. I am fully prepared.
All right, let's continue the exam. Hemorrhaging spots near the navel. Roni, write that down.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Blood spots near navel.
Hemorrhaging spots on the left side of his abdomen. Roni, put that in his record.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Blood spots on left of abdomen.
All right, let's ask you more questions.
I'm sorry that I lied all this time. It's not just my tummy. My back's been starting to hurt too.
Back pains. This condition must be getting worse. Roni, make a note.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Back pains.
It doesn't hurt so much that I can't bear it, but it hurts a lot. Also, I don't feel well.
Feels like he's going to vomit, huh? Sounds like he's finally telling the truth about something. Roni, this is important.
Doctor, new symptom observed. Nausea.
If there's anything more, I'll tell you right away, Doctor.
I shouldn't pull the gut in this trick. Alright, let me go to my office.
Well, we have his symptoms. Roni, let's narrow down our diagnosis.
Understood, Doctor. I'll get things ready for you.
Digest it? Oh.
But I find it hard to believe this could have caused the relapse of his gastric ulcers. Damn it. There's still something else. Roni, I'm continuing with the diagnosis. Not done yet.
Indeed, Doctor. I will follow your lead.
Phase 3.
Acute pancreatitis? That can't be the primary disease.
It is plausible the chief illness caused it, like the ulcers.
What's going on?
We can only hope our examination will answer that, Doctor.
Yeah. I hate dealing with all these complications.
Confirmed onset of pancreatitis unrelated to gastric ulcers. Diagnosis will continue.
So have you figured out what's wrong with me, Doctor?
It's going to take a little longer. We need to keep examining you, but is your body all right?
It still hurts a little, but you're gonna fix me soon, right?
That's right. Hang in there. But if it gets too much to handle, you tell us right away, okay?
Okay, I promise.
All right, let's resume with the diagnosis.
All right, kid.
Anything else that's weird? I'm not hiding anything anymore. I've started getting real thirsty.
I see. This is polydipsia and polyuria. It's small, but it's crucial. Roni, make a note.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Polydipsia and polyuria.
Well, if he's thirsty and he's drinking more, it makes sense that he's using the bathroom more.
That's it. Is that important? It's kind of embarrassing.
Calcium is way past the average levels. Roni, you got that one?
Yes, Doctor. New symptom observed. High blood calcium level.
This is high too.
Yep. Abnormally high PRL blood level. Roni, mark it down.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. High PRL blood level.
Ooh, that's high.
The serum gastrin level seems unusually high. Roni, record that.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. High serum gastrin level.
See, I have a pair of comfier headphones, but they broke. They don't sit on my head very well. Oh.
His intact PTH is showing some very high levels. Roni, put it in his chart.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. High intact PTH level.
It doesn't match anything. Okay, I'm missing something.
Yo, Joshua. Doing all right?
Oh, doctor. Yeah, it hurts a little, but I'm all right.
I see. I'm sorry. Just a little longer.
See, he's still a good dad. He tries. Missing something.
Thank you.
Oh, here we go.
Serum phosphorus level is abnormally low. Roni, another piece of the puzzle.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed.
What the heck? A number of abnormal levels have suddenly appeared.
The cause is unknown, but the analysis is at least 97% reliable.
I know. That's why I'm worried. Let's go back to my office. I need to sort through the latest data.
Okay, now I've got stuff.
Now, time to narrow down our candidates and see if we can't find the culprit.
I have more than two things now. Oh, God. Alright, still hyperparathyroidism. Low serum phosphorus.
There's a number of symptoms which don't apply. But hyperparathyroidism seems to be the closest match, right?
Scintigraphy and X-ray examinations will be necessary to make a definitive diagnosis.
Hmm. Well, then let's get approval right away.
Understood, Doctor. Request has been approved. The X-ray and scintigraphy exams are now available.
Image analysis lab. Oh my God. I can't speak today.
The X-ray and scintigraphy results are ready for your review.
Sounds good. Let's get to it then. Absorption must be advancing. Roni, add this to our list.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Subperiosteal bone resorption.
Accumulation of technetium in the parathyroid gland. There's no mistaking it. It's parathyroid adenoma.
Understood, Doctor. New symptom observed. Parathyroid adenoma.
To my office.
Clear that hyperparathyroidism has set in, but what about the symptoms that don't apply?
Doctor, until the primary disease has been identified, we must continue the diagnosis.
Yeah, no turning back now. We need to figure this thing out. Joshua, are you all right?
Huh? Oh, when did you come in, Doctor?
I walk in. I'm assuming I come in through this door, right?
You didn't notice?
Something's weird. It's like I can't see very well.
You can't see very well? Can you tell me more?
Uh-huh. Okay. I really didn't see you come in, Doctor. mean, it's weird, right?
Sheesh.
But I totally didn't see when you came in. And my head hurts too.
Stomach aches, back pains, and now headaches. This has to be hard on him.
I mean, you get used to it when everything hurts all the time.
I need to find the answer quickly.
I agree, Doctor. New symptom observed. Headaches.
Say how I found the symptoms. Oh, cool. I've never just hovered over them before. There are areas where the patient obviously differs from a healthy person. I know. I need to figure out what's causing this. Oh, is there like swelling on his neck or anything?
Field loss.
He said the same.
Joshua, where is it hard to see? Is it the right and left edges of your eyes?
Huh? Oh, I think so. I can't see right and left.
Just as I thought. It could be in the eyes. It could be in the brain. We need to do an MRI.
Understood, Doctor. No symptom observed. Visual field loss. And the MRI exam is now available.
Honestly, they should have let you pick either one of those because it's the same thing, essentially. I'll be back. Alright, let's check out this MRI.
Doctor, the MRI examination results are ready for your review.
Alright, let's check them right away.
There we go.
Huh? Pituitary gland's gotten so large. No question. This is a pituitary gland tumor.
New symptom observed. Tumor shadow on pituitary gland.
Yes. To the office.
Symptoms seem to point to pituitary adenoma?
You saw it.
First, the parathyroid gland, now the pituitary gland. Damn it, what in the world?
Doctor, I have located one case in the archives which matches this scenario.
What? I didn't tell you to do that. How'd you...
I applied the to hell with that algorithm recently entered into my registry and made a judgment call.
Huh? The apple doesn't fall far from the tree, huh? Even a robo-apple. Now, this is the kind of partner a doctor should have at his side.
Yes, Doctor. I have indeed been designated as your partner. But the news is not good. This is a disease where the probability of onset is 1 in 10,000.
Where is it? Show me the data immediately.
Yes, Doctor. I have added this diagnosis candidate to your database.
Got it.
There it is. Because we were treating him for this in the surgery. A condition in which tumors form on multiple glands in the endocrine system, such as the pituitary gland, parathyroid gland, and parotid gland? I don't actually know how to say that one. Symptoms include headache, visual fluid loss, polydipsia, and polyuria. Analysis will reveal abnormalities such as high L level, high calcium, low serum, high intact OPTH, high this thing, X-ray will reveal, I'm not saying that again. Yep, subperiosteal. See, that's easy to say. In the fingers, tumors in the pituitary glands can be formed. MRI scintigraphy will confirm this.
Wormer syndrome? That's impossible!
I must disagree, Doctor. The probability of this match is roughly 73%.
To verify this, we need to check for pancreatic tumors.
While there should be tumor shadows on the pancreas in the CT exam, they'll be very small and difficult to discern.
Ronan, order a CT scan so I can examine the patient's pancreas.
Dr. Cunningham, should I also request that the patient be assigned to another doctor?
Don't make me repeat myself. I don't pick and choose my patients. I'm a diagnostician. I find the symptoms, I diagnose the disease. That's all there is to it.
Understood. The CT examination is now available.
Alright, let's go check these CT scans. Please don't be fine with them.
The CT examination results are ready for you to check.
That's good. Let's see them.
What did I just say? Okay, look. Oh god. I'm looking at pancreas. And they're small tumors, so they're hard to see. I don't actually remember where the pancreas is. Oh, wait. so here's Reddit. Is that little itty bitty thing right there? It.
Pancreatic tumors, all right. Roni, I need to make sure of this. Collate it with the case data.
Understood. Now collating. 9 matches with previous cases confirmed. These are pancreatic tumors.
I see. You know, I think for once, I'm not so excited about your accuracy.
New symptom observed. Tumor shadows on the pancreas.
But at least we know how it turns out. Survives. Okay, back to my office. There we go. And turn your shadows on the pancreas.
Needs to be dealt with at once. If his condition worsens any more.
We did it.
Damn it.
This is bad, Gabe. Joshua's only getting worse.
It's Warmer syndrome. He's going into septic shock. I'll leave the treatment to the other staff.
What? Joshua's your son. Get over there and go see him.
Me going there won't change anything. I gave my diagnosis. The rest is up to you guys.
Huh? You are an absolute disgrace.
I mean, he shouldn't even be diagnosing his son at all.
You are incorrect, Dr. Cunningham.
What?
I observed tension in your vocal cords just now. Your words are not congruous with your true feelings.
And? What? You mean you can tell everything about me? Am I that wrong? Is everything my fault? I can't make him happy as a father. I can't use a scalpel and save him myself. Nothing I could do! Nothing, damn it!
Nothing other than property damage.
It was all pointless. Everything. Hey, Roni. You know what? I'm the worst father out there. What do you know? You're right. I can't believe a machine talks some sense into me. Roni, get ready for surgery. Contact the ERN nursing.
The operation can begin in 5 minutes.
Doctor, I am broken.
I won't let Joshua die.
I can't do anything.
As a doctor, or as his father.
Let's go.
Yeah, realistically, he wouldn't. If he's estranged, I don't know, because... I don't know. What a weird situation. Event? Is it the same? Oh yeah, I don't get graded on diagnostics. Oh, that's just a... That's just a cutscene. That's not a episode. Okay, that's interesting. But I think I'm gonna call it here. I'm getting kind of hungry. Ooh, and I have tacos left over. I'm gonna make some tacos. But I hope you all enjoyed this stream, and I hope I will catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching.